Hello friends, welcome to Planet to Soul Astrology. So today we'll discuss about Navmas chart part 2. So whoever have not still watched my part 1 of Navmas chart, please go through it so that it will be easy for you all to understand Navmas chart 2. So before starting, I would like to tell few things about Navmas chart. That is, whenever there are few rules and observations in Navmas chart which have been mentioned in many classics. So whenever any planet is in the same Rashi, in your D9 chart also, it becomes Virgottam planet. Say for example, if you have Jupiter in Cancer sign, and in D9 also, if Jupiter is remaining in the Cancer sign, then this Jupiter becomes Virgottama. Same with if this Jupiter is in Taurus, and in D9 also, if it remains in Taurus sign, then it becomes Virgottama. So this planet becomes more powerful to give its fruits in best possible ways. But at the same time, if you have any exalted planet in D1 chart, but in your D9 chart, if this planet is becoming debilitated or this planet is going in 6, 8, 12 houses in the D9 chart, or this planet is going in enemy sign in D9, then this planet loses its strength to give the fruits. So this planet will not fruit you fully in its dasha, antar dasha, and during the transit period also. So we have to first see that what is the actual strength of all the planets of our chart in our D9 chart also. Many a times, if you have any debilitated planet or any low strength planet in your D1 chart, that is natal chart, but if this planet is becoming exalted in your D9 chart, then this planet will definitely give you very good fruits. Many a times we see a chart, and if we see the debilitation of any planet, we say, this planet will not fruit good to you in its dasha, antar dasha. But we have to see its position in D9 also. If this planet is promising, then definitely it will give good fruits in the negative. But at the same time, again, I am telling that if any say for example, Jupiter is of Cancer in your D1 chart, but in D9 chart, if it is becoming of Capricorn, then definitely it will lose its strength to give the fruits. Other things I would like to say here, that if any planet in your D9 chart, say for example, the Atmakarak planet, means the planet which have highest degree in your chart is called as Atmakarak planet. For example, if you have Mercury in your chart of say 22 degree, and the remaining all 8 planets are less than 22 or 23 degrees, then Mercury becomes your Atmakarak planet. So whole your life will run around the Mercury only. You will be having most features and characteristics of Mercury in your life. So Atmakarak planet becomes the major factor to read the Navmas Kundali. So just see that where this Atmakarak planet is placed in your Navmas chart. If this now in Navmas chart, this Atmakarak planet is placed in 5th house, 9th house or Lagna house or ascendant, it will definitely give you very good fruits. Then again you see that here this Atmakarak planet is of which nakshatra, and where is that nakshatra lord placed in Navmas chart also. Means that becomes a deeper study. But first attempt, if you want to learn Navmas, you have to keep all these things in mind. And from that Atmakarak planet, you have to start reading the chart. You can do it in D9 also. And you can do it in D1 chart also. Means in your D1 chart, if Surya is becoming your Atmakara planet, then you read the chart by putting the Surya Kundali. Same way, this Surya, wherever placed in your D9 chart, you have to start reading the chart from that Karakansh Kundali. That is called as Karakansh Kundali. So this really fruits great and gives reading very accurate in our predictions and in for learning also, for researching also. This will definitely give you the best idea of reading any chart, including all the divisional charts. Now, going ahead, if in Naumansha chart, if in your D1 chart, if any planet is in a fiery element, and if in Naumansha chart this planet is going in, say, airy element, then it becomes more prone to give fruits of aggressiveness. And if it is a planet like Mars, then this person's nature becomes more aggressive because this air and this fire are precipitating each other to give fruits, and in combined, the air is supporting this fire element to give its fruit more and more, and that burning fire is always there in the native. Same way, you have to see the water element as well as fire element, then fire element and earth element, everything you have to correlate. So for this, you must know the all five elements in deep, all pancha tattva also you must know. So this all things we have to see while assessing the Naumansha chart. Again, in while assessing the Naumansha chart, you have to see that which in Ashtakvarga also which planet has been given the maximum marks and in which house that planet is placed in your D9 chart, and whether this planet's dasha antar dasha is going to come or no. Again, in transit also, how this planet will give fruits. You just have to superimpose the Naumansha chart on your natal chart, or your natal chart on your Naumansha chart. This is called as Rashi Tulya Naumansha or Naumansha Tulya Rashi. Both ways you can judge the chart. But as soon as you learn reading the chart, you will understand this. In P.S. Patel book, this is mentioned very very nicely and very in such a way that you will understand the basic concept of this Rashi Tulya Naumansha and Naumansha Tulya Rashi. Then deep study of Naumansha gets started. Basically for seventh house related things we see for Naumansha, but we have to think beyond it. We have to see the total strength of each planet in Naumansha chart. So today we will talk about one chart, and I will show you that how I will just show you the basic idea of reading the Naumansha chart. So today we will take Mr. Amitabh Bachchan's chart. So this personality is known to everybody. I hope you all can see the chart. So, if you see in this is his Lagna chart and this is his Naumansha chart. Here also it is Lagna chart. So, if you see Mr. Amitabh Bachchan's Kundali, he is having Aquarius Lagna rising in his D1 chart, but this Aquarius Lagna is of 21 degree. So the first Naumansha of Aquarius, that is Aries sign always goes in the Libra starting Naumansha. But as it is of 21 degree, so the seventh Naumansha from Libra sign, seventh zodiac sign is coming as a Aries. That is why in D9 chart, he is having Aries as a rising Naumansha because of this 21 degree 35 kala. If it could have been more than 23 degrees, then it could have gone in 8th Navamsha of Taurus over here. But it is between the 20 degree and 23, 20 degree. So the 7th Navamsha is coming starting from the Libra. Same way, then we have to put all the, if you are doing it manually, if you want to learn it manually, you have to see the degrees and then just you have to make the placement. Now here I will explain you about the Jupiter. See, in Mr. Amitabh Bachchan's chart, Jupiter is placed in Cancer sign. That is of 0 degree. And for any watery sign, the first Navamsha starts from its own Navamsha, that is Cancer only. That is why in D9 chart also, this Cancer is remained in Cancer sign only. So this Jupiter has become Vargottama for Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. Along with that, Mars is also there in his D9 chart along with this Jupiter, which is a making a Mahalakshmi Yoga or a Lakshmi Yoga, which will fruit best to the native in terms of all type of lavish material life, good house, many properties, vehicle, everything, because these both planets are coming in 4th house of Sukhasthan, 4th house of comfort zone. These planets are coming. Mars and Jupiter, they make very good friends with each other. And in D9 also, if you see, this Mars is Lagnesh. Ascendant Lord is coming with Vargottama planet Jupiter. Now here if you see his birth nakshatra, as per ascendant is Purva Bhadrapada, and as per moon sign, here as per moon sign, he is having Swati nakshatra, that is Rahu nakshatra. So Rahu, if you see as per Tara Bal, Rahu nakshatra becomes his Janmatara. And after Rahu, always which nakshatra comes? After Rahu, it comes Jupiter nakshatra. Any Rahu nakshatra, if you take, the second nakshatra from Rahu comes of Jupiter nakshatra. So in Mr. Amitabh Bachchan's chart, Rahu is the Janmatara, and second from Swati nakshatra is Vishakha nakshatra of Jupiter, which becomes his Sampat Tara. So by birth he got Rahu Dasha, as he was born in Swati Nakshatra in 1955, and then Jupiter Mahadasha started in his life, which is his Sampattara, which is the best fruit giver planet and the best planet in his chart. This Jupiter is giving him all the success, but this Jupiter gave him fruits in the mid of this Jupiter Dasha, not before that. Rahu becoming Janmatara, his birth and his life pattern was very normal. Then gradually he started getting a growth. As soon as he started the film Saath Hindustani. Now why he went in acting field? Why? So in D1 chart, if you see this Venus, Mars, Mercury, Sun, all these four planets are in his 8th house, but Mercury is exalted, so Venus is debilitated, but because of this Mercury, this Venus is getting Nich Bhanga Yoga. So this Venus is becoming auspicious to give its fruit in terms of money. More if you see about the Navamsha chart, here in Navamsha chart, this Venus is becoming of own sign and also it is holding the earth element. Here also it is in earth element, and here also it is in earth element, so it is becoming more powerful to give the fruits. Again, one more thing in the 9 chart about Venus, I would like to tell you all that for any earth sign, the first Naumansha will start from Capricorn, as his Venus is of 15 degree. So from Capricorn, if you start, the 15 degree comes around 5th Naumansha of earth sign also. So this is holding the same earth Naumansha, earth element in the 9 charts. So again this Venus is becoming Ati Shubh, and again this Venus is placed in his Dhanasthan, finance house. So he is earning money through Venus related things in the 9 chart. Venus is his Chaturtha Mansha, means his heart, his soul is in acting, in creativity, all type of creative work he will be best in. Now why he got so much of popularity, that we will see. So popularity in routine we see 7th house, okay, 4th house also. So here it is a sign of Leo in his 7th house, and here in the 9 Ravi, that is Sun and Mercury, are placed in his 5th house together, being a lord of 7th zodiac sign. This Mercury and Sun are together, which is giving him the best to best popularity and success in his life. This is a Purva Punya house also. So he has brought certain Purva Karmas, Purva Punya, that this house got more and more enhanced to give him the best fruits in his life, best popularity. After acting, he was offered politics and all other things. But first thing was his acting. Now in his chart, if you see, this Sun is holding 24 degree, more than any degrees. So Sun is the Atma Karak planet in Mr. Amitabh Bachchan's chart. And this Atma Karak planet is placed with Mercury, Taraka of acting, the 5th house of creativity. So Sun and Mercury both together are giving him the best type of fruits in terms of media success. Now from Karakash Kundali also you see, that is from Sun Kundali, if we see, the Venus is coming at 10th house from Karkansh Kundali, that is a profession house. So again this Venus is giving him the profession related to acting. So as per Karkansh Kundali also, we are able to prove it, that his profession is into acting only. And here again you see Moon and Venus both are making, trying to each other. So all material things, all lavish life, popularity, known and wanted by each and every person, is this Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. Now if we see, this Jupiter is playing the major role in his chart. So whenever Jupiter Dasha, Antar Dasha or in transit will come in his 6th house, he will get enhancement, or this Jupiter will lift him up in his profession. Even he is having Dirghayu Yoga. because he is running very good age, very good health also. In between, he got certain problems in his Ketu Dasha also. He got many problems, but as soon as Ketu Dasha was over, again his life started a peak. So this Venus Dasha is again giving him the best fruits. If you see about Saturn, so here in his D1 chart, if you see, this Saturn is placed in fourth house. This Saturn in D9 chart is going in Mithuna Rashi, that is Gemini sign, with Rahu. So again in Parakrama house, this Saturn gave him gradual growth in his work. All of a sudden he was not a superstar or Mahanayak, what you say, great actor. But step by step, slow and steady, he got all these fruits. Now if you see, this Saturn and Rahu are placed 9th to his 7th house. So Saturn will always keep his growth in gradual way. So from his D9 chart, we come to know whole of his life cycle. He is more into spirituality also. He is a good meditator, because if you see, this Ketu is placed in his 9th house in D9 chart, which is his Lagna Mancha, because here Ketu is placed in his Lagna Sthan. But where is the zodiac of Sagittarius? That is in 11th house. So Ketu is his Lahansha. So always in spirituality also, his Ketu will give him good fruits, and out of any danger situation, his Ketu will help him out to come out from that situation. As the Janmatara is Rahu, then Jupiter is his Sambattara, then Saturn is his Vipattara. So we have to consider this Tarabal also. Then Sampat, Vipat, Shem. Then after that, Mercury becomes his Shematara. Then further we have to see all the Tarabal. So according to this Tarabal, according to Karkansh Kundali, this D9 chart works best in his Kundali. One more thing I would like to add here. If you see Mr. Amitabh Bachchan's chart, as per Chandra Kundali, this chart works a lot. If you see from Chandra Kundali, this Kundali is creating typical Gajakesari Yog in this chart. From Moon, this Chandra is coming in 10th house. So after struggle also, he is getting the best of fruits. And this is a typical sign of Gajakesari Yoga. And also Hansa Yoga is created in his chart, because Jupiter is exalted. Mercury is also exalted, which is creating a Bhadra Yoga in his chart. So he is having two of the major Panchamahapurush Yogas in his chart. One more thing, in Jupiter Dasha, he got the maximum success and he got the maximum support in Jupiter Dasha, because this Jupiter is coming in his Pushkar Navmansha also. So I hope you all understood the basic idea of this D9 chart. So we have to see the proper strength of D9 chart. If we see about the 7th house matter, his wife is also into acting, Mrs. Jaya Bachchan. So here if you see, in his 7th place zodiac, Mercury and Sun is coming. Again connectivity with acting. And because of this Rahu in 7th house in D1 chart, he may not get along very good with his spouse. That is all their personal matter, so we cannot discuss more about it. We should just discuss the professional life of him. But if you see this Rahu and Ketu, whenever Rahu comes in the 7th house, it disturbs the marital place. But here, if you see 12th to 7th house is a Jupiter, which is keeping the road, which is keeping a smooth marital life for Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. And here all these four planets, so this Rahu is getting hammed between these all planets. So we have to consider that also. So this was all about D9 chart. Hope you all understand. Please put the queries. And I read all the comments, whatever you all are writing, but I am not able to answer each and every one. But I am reading it, and whichever I find it more suitable query or I answer those queries. So please go on doing the comments. Please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and please suggest if you need anything more about the D9 chart. So thank you all, and God bless you. Bye bye.